Obeying the Gospel, March 11th, Born Again. Jesus answered him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." John 3, verse 3. Obeying the Gospel involves the deepest change possible in a human being's heart. Dying to sin and living in newness of life, as Paul says in Romans 6, verse 4, is more than adopting a different religious affiliation, accepting a different set of beliefs, or attending services at a different church. It is becoming a different person. Jesus said, "Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." In John 3, verse 5, Jesus was more specific. "Unless one is born of the water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God." What does this mean? It means, first, that the act of baptism, immersion in water, precedes our entrance into God's kingdom. But born of water, we are also born of the Spirit. At baptism, the Christian begins learning to lay aside his self-will and yield himself to the direction of God's Spirit. This guidance is available for us today in the Scriptures that were revealed by the Spirit, 2 Timothy 3, 16 and 17. Paul wrote that God has saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewal of the Holy Spirit, Titus 3, verse 5. Here we see once again the water and the Spirit of which Jesus spoke in John 3, 5. Beginning with the remission of our sins at baptism, a strong renewal takes place. As we learn more of God's will, we begin to be led, directed, and governed by God's Spirit. And as we obey God's command to walk in the Spirit, the works of the flesh begin to be replaced by the fruit of the Spirit, Galatians 5, verses 16 through 26. As you can see, being born again involves something that happens to us, the remission of our sins, and also something we do, live a new life. By His grace, God has forgiven us, and He will help us obey Him. But to remain in the kingdom, we must accept the rule of the King. As Paul said, "The Spirit has given us life, He must also control our lives," Galatians 5:25 in the Good News Bible. If the problem of sin is to be corrected, radical surgery must be done. The gospel does not deal in superficial solutions. According to Jesus, it is not our dysfunctional behavior that is the problem, it is us. It is in the deepest depths of our hearts that we need to change. We must, in fact, die and become new people altogether. Oswald Chambers wrote, "Being born again is a foundational fact. The characteristic of the new birth is that I yield myself so completely to God that Christ is formed in me."